Investigative journalist Diane Diamond broke the news of the child molestation charges against Michael Jackson back in 1993. She has covered him ever since. She is the author of Be Careful Who You Love, Inside the Michael Jackson Case. Good morning, Diane.
Good morning, Maggie.
And you have been saying for a long time that Michael Jackson is not the biological father of his children.
That's right. That's
right. How do you
know? Well, it was sort of an open secret among a small cadre of people close to him, and some of those people were my sources, have been for a long time.
What else do you know about this dermatologist that is reportedly the father? Are you convinced he is the biological father of two of the children?
Absolutely. And you know, I wish I knew someone who did that age regression, because if you look at the older child and
the one
put
there
it,
on the right,
exactly, and put it next to this man's face, to me they look so similar. What do I know about him? He is a prominent Beverly Hills dermatologist, has a lot of stars, has a lot of regular people as his clients. He's very well liked. He's very active in AIDS charity. You know, all around nice guy. Nobody has anything bad to say about Arnie Klein. The only thing I would say is he would do anything for Michael Jackson. And that's one reason the police want to talk to him, or may have already talked to him, about all the prescriptions he has written for Michael Jackson over the years, or has gotten other doctors to write for Michael.
They're looking at him supposedly for prescription fraud.
Exactly.
What lengths do you think he went to for Michael Jackson?
Well, here's what we know. I mean, because I could speculate till the cows come home,
That's
as they
right.
say. But there is a pharmacy, the Mickey Fine Pharmacy, that you were just listening to about. And at one time, Michael Jackson was getting $48,000 a month of prescriptions through that place. That's in the same building, same area as Arnie Klein's office. I know from police detectives and from the trial that many vials of narcotic drugs and prescription pills were taken from his nightstand under other people's names. And I think this is maybe how it worked. Lots of different names, all charged to Michael Jackson's account. And at one point, Mickey Fine Pharmacy wasn't being paid, so they sued Michael Jackson for a $100,000 unpaid bill.
No, this is not confirmed. This is what you believe to be true, correct?
No, there was a lawsuit filed for $100,000.
So why is this just all coming out now? Why didn't somebody see this sooner, before he died of so far unknown causes?
Yeah, that's a good question. And you know what? I think it all comes back to the doctors who serviced him. Not only the ones that did all the cosmetic surgery on his face, but everyone that wrote him a narcotics prescription.
All right. Diane Diamond, thank you.
You bet.